How are you guys? Hi, Jen. I've never done a live on a Sunday night, so I wanted to see how good of a night it was to get people here. If you saw my Instagram story, this live I'm going to talk about business. How I started my business, how much money I started with. I'm gonna get rid of these spammers. How do I do that? Just in my PJs. My husband doesn't play video games, but he watches a lot of YouTube So I'm gonna give a minute for a couple more of you guys to join. And I'm gonna pull my notes up on my computer. Because my laptop just got jacked. Can everybody hear me? I'm doing it on my iPad this time instead of my phone, and so I don't have to hold it the whole time. If you've ever watched, I usually hold the phone. And so give me a heart if you can hear me. Okay, good, thanks. I'm glad someone can hear me. Okay, so I'm gonna give 1 more minute to pe for people to join, and then we're gonna talk business. As I look up my notes real quick. That you're pumping and nursing at the same time. I had twins, so I did a lot of that. I thought today was a good day too to do this. If you've ever watched my lives, I normally don't get ready, but I was ready today for the day, so I was like, I think I need to do a live. Okay, so I'm gonna go over a couple things. I'm gonna make this like 30 minutes or less so I don't take all of your time. You can go do whatever you need to do. 30 minutes is still kind of a long time. If you ask a question, please do not be vague. Ask a specific question. Like, oh, what color is that shirt you're wearing? Don't just say what shirt or something like that because sometimes I see the question later and I get confused and I don't know what it is and I want to make sure I answer everyone's question. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to go over, how I started my business. Hopefully, those of you that are joining late, you can kind of catch up. So I started in 2010. Well, in 2008, I went to cosmetology school. I wanted to do hair my whole life, right? And then jump start to 2010. One of my friends in Las Vegas, she said, "You need to do eyelash extensions. It's the biggest, it's the newest thing." So I didn't really have a lot of money. I was a poor student. I had just had a baby. My life was kind of like this, all over the place. I actually took out a $10,000 loan from school to live because I was so poor. And then my course was $500, my first eyelash class. I took my first eyelash class, and my instructor was like, "You're really good at this. I want you to work for me." So she kind of gave me like a confidence boost, like, oh, and I was like, okay, I'm good at this. I did my full sets, you know, in 2 hours. And anyway, so I did a couple people's lashes, and I was like, oh, I really like this. I was kind of just doing it out of my home for fun. Just because I had a new baby. My baby was just a couple months old. And then I ended up becoming a single mom, maybe 2 or 3 months later, right? So then I'm like very, very, very not financially stable at all, right? So I'm like living on someone's couch, a very nice friend of mine, me and my like pretty new baby. And I went around to all the salons in the area that we live in, and this was in 2010, so eyelash extensions were very new, and they all offered me a job. And I'm gonna go through this story quick so that you're not bored, but I ended up choosing a salon to work at that was booth rent. And for me, I wanted to make the most amount of money that I could, so for me, booth rent seemed like that was the option to go. So I did a booth rent space, and I was very, very motivated. I was 19 or 20, and I didn't have any money, and I was a single mom. So what I did was I went around to almost every business I could think of that would attract people that would want eyelash extensions. So I went to tanning salons. I went to hair salons. I went to gyms. I went to aerobic gyms. I went to bridal stores. I went everywhere. And I told the person that worked at the front desk, I said, if I do your eyelashes for free, will you send everyone that you know or everyone that asks about your eyelashes that comes into this business, tell them about me, tell them to come get the service done by me. And that's what I did when I very first started. And then Groupon had very first come out. So I contacted Groupon, and a couple of you guys have probably heard this story. I sold, I can't remember now, somewhere between 100 and 200 Groupons. So that's how I built my clientele. I basically went knocking on people's doors, asking them to be my client, you know? And the Groupon was successful for me at that time. I don't know how they are now, but I did do mine in 2011. It was very successful. But I feel like going around to all those businesses, you know, people, you can't think that business is going to come knocking at your door. You have to go find it. And at first you have to do a lot of work for free and bend over backwards and put a lot of effort into your business. It doesn't just, you know, people, especially sometimes when you go to hair school and aesthetic school, you have the mindset like, oh, I'm going to do this and then I'm going to have a clientele and life is going to be great. Well, you have to work hard for your clientele, and then you have to maintain that clientele, right? Okay, so that was the first thing that I wanted to go over. I walked around and went everywhere that I could, right, to get my clients. So I ended up, within 3 weeks, I ended up making enough money to get my own place, and then within 2 years, I was able to pay off my $10,000 school loan debt, which is a big deal, right? So how did I get that far? And at this point, I was still a single mom, and I was living and thriving, and I was fine. So how did I get to pay off my student loan debt quickly, and also continue to build my business, right? So I put a lot of the money that I made from my business back into my business because I liked where I was at, but I wanted to continue to grow, right? So, and what I mean by putting back into your business, think of ways that you can better your business. And what I did also is I have one person, she's a businesswoman, she's not in the beauty industry. She's actually in the baby industry, but I found one person that I absolutely love. I love how she runs her business, the style of her business. I love her as a person. And I knew, you are a very successful woman. I want to be like you. So I kind of watched what she did and how she marketed her business or the things she did, like what giveaways she did or who she partnered with. And her business is actually called Freshly Picked. You can look them up on Instagram. She sells baby moccasins. But I've just followed her for a while and I loved how she ran her business. So honestly, a lot of the ideas that I do, I've kind of bounced off of her. She doesn't even know who I am or anything at all remotely close to that I even exist, really. But yeah, so she was kind of like I idolized her, I guess you could say. So find a person that you are like, I love, and it could be, yes, mentoring. And it could be someone, it doesn't have to be in your same industry, you know, mine wasn't, but it could be in your same industry. You know, if you feel like, okay, I want to be better at this, or I want to be better at that, find, say you want your work to be better. Find someone who on Instagram, probably, whose work that you're like, her work is beautiful. And kind of just follow her and see, you know, pay attention to the things that you're liking. Does she have a wide fan or does she have a narrow fan? Do you like either of those? Or do you like the shape that she's doing? What is it that you're liking about her work? Do you like how she edits her photos? Do you like the caption she says in her photos? So find someone successful that you love what they're doing and kind of use them as your mentor. It's always great to have a mentor. So going back to put your money back into your business and see how you can better your business, right? So bettering your business, they can be small and simple things. So I want to encourage you guys all to try and do, let's say, maybe one better your business thing a month. Is that too much to ask? Yes, yes, yes. I do love critiquing. So it can be something small, like to better your business, you can add, email or text messaging reminder appointments, right? So instead of your clients, maybe you say, okay, we book your appointment for Monday at 10 a.m. Maybe you can get some sort of app or some sort of email system that can remind them of it. That way you have less no-shows. So do something small like that, or maybe you've had these sheets on your bed, the same sheets for 3 years. Maybe update your sheets, or just do a simple little makeover in one little area. You know, if I was like, and I don't mean, you're still waiting for your critique. I know I'm being slow on those. I don't mean like go redo your whole eyelash room and buy all new pictures. And I mean, if you have the funds and the energy and the time to do that, then, and you feel like your place needs it, then definitely do that. Also, a huge thing that I recommend is taking one course a year, and it doesn't have to be an eyelash course. Like, so I did end up taking five eyelash courses, five or six maybe, over time now. But I got to a point now where I'm like, I don't think I need any more lash classes. Now I want business classes. So I've taken social media courses, I've taken email marketing courses, I've taken photography courses, and those are all things that, one, will be tax write-offs because it's for your business, and two, they're bettering me. They may not be bettering the way that I do eyelashes, but I felt like I didn't need anymore as much bettering in that area as I did in other areas, right? So always be investing back into your business. So some of the things that I did, as I said in my Insta story, I was like, I'll tell you what I sacrificed. So I feel like I sacrificed paying myself. We actually still don't pay ourselves much. We put a lot of our money back into our business. We just feel like that's where it needs to be able to grow where we want to be. Vision boards are awesome. And goals. You need to set goals every month, or you're just going to kind of be floating, right? Like, no plan, just being a little swimmer. That was kind of gross. Oh, that's a good question. Were the eyelash courses with the same companies or different? And were they different courses? I never took an eyelash course from the same company. I always took them from someone different, and it was always someone whose work I loved. Loved. So I would say go after someone whose work you love. And you also have to love them as a person, because you have to be able to get along with them, which can play a lot into it. I forgot what I was talking about before I answered her question. Take one course a year, and I'm not going to answer product questions right now. I'm so sorry. I'll answer them at the end, maybe. Just so we stay on topic for those that I promised topics to. Hello, Lashpreneur. Now I'm nervous. There's so many people here. Oh, no, you're fine. Don't be sorry. Oh, set goals and you were a little swimmer. Okay, so if you don't set goals, right, you'll just be like a little swimmer in life. You'll have no idea what you want to do. Thank you, Mackenzie. So for example, obviously I don't do lashes anymore. Now, my business has gone into mainly products. Probably about 85%, 90% of our business is based solely on product distribution. So we set a sales goal every month, okay? And during the month, we do things to make sure that we hit that goal. We don't just say, I hope a lot of people order today. you know, we're constantly working toward, we're talking to our customers. I go after people. I try to find new customers. And say, okay, we have 5 days left of the month. Then at the end of those days, you know, we go over all our stats or analytics of how much we've brought in. And if we haven't hit our goal yet, then we're going to be sending out emails, or we're going to be doing a sale, or we're going to be doing something to make sure that we hit that goal. And I've never not hit a goal. I don't know if that means that I don't make big enough goals, which I think I actually really do, because sometimes I'm like, oh, we're not going to do that. And then we do, and then we exceed it. So set goals and then put things into action to help you reach your goal. Don't just say, okay, this is what I'm going to do. And a good thing to do is, like, I have a whiteboard and I'll write down what my goal is that month. This is what I want to do. And I feel like seeing it every day as a reminder, that can really help you. So that goes back into dream boards. So, you know, there's things that we want in life. We wanted a boat. We wanted a couple children. Just things that we wanted. So those are something that I would put on my dream board. You know, or I want to go on a vacation to Hawaii, or I want to have 50 clients a month, you know. And put that dream board where you can see it somewhere as your daily reminder. So you can have a dream board, or you can write your daily mantra or monthly mantra or whatever it is that you want to remind yourself of what you want to hit, right? At what point did you decide to move away from lashing to distribution? That's a huge step. Okay, so when I started, I took my first eyelash class. I taught my first student within 4 weeks, and I also went into distribution within 4 weeks. When I started, I was very motivated. I'm a very, very go-getter person. I'm not like I'm too scared. I don't let pride or I don't let fear get, fear and pride will destroy you if you let it. So don't let it. You know, and I'm not scared because I always think, I always think it through before I do it, right? I did it all within a month. And it wasn't huge, you know. Keep in mind that I need a charger. Hold on. When I started doing, I need to move this. Shoot. We need to plug this in. Oh. Okay, I'm gonna hope I don't drop this iPad. Here goes nothing. I have to raise this. Oh, okay. We'll be good. We'll be good. Don't you worry. So, hold on. Oh, where's the plug? Okay, so when I started doing eyelash extensions, I cannot multitask. Bless me. There we go. We're plugged in. Okay, when I first started doing eyelash extensions, there weren't very many products. So when we first started our product line, there was C curl and D curl. And there were no volume lashes. So we sold just a few lash trays, just a few tweezers and glue and iPads. And I had a very small stock because I didn't have any customers. It was just me saying, I want to make more money, so I want to sell this product. So we started very slow. There was no Instagram. So again, it was me working really hard to build a customer base. It was like I was starting all over. I had my eyelash clientele, but I just started slowly. And I was training. So I don't know. I started slowly, and then I've also had, you know, a lot of bad experiences, but I wouldn't call them bad experiences. For example, we found a manufacturer at one point. This was about 5 years ago. We found a manufacturer. This is before we have our amazing lashes right now, right? And the lashes went flat within a few weeks. The eyelash extensions went flat. And I want to say something that hopefully does not hurt. Well, it's the truth, and the truth hurts. So, oh, sometimes I need a filter. So, why do eyelash extensions go flat? And I feel like I'm going off topic. Basically, if you're, and when I found these, they were cheap. And I was like, oh, and if it's too good to be true, it's too good to be true. So those eyelashes that we were having manufactured, this was 5 years ago, not right now, just to clarify. They were made of cheaper materials and they were not made properly. So the curl straightened out. So if you ever have a lash tray that happens, it's not an accident or it's not a bad batch. It is their product sucks. So you should probably switch. Okay, I can't decide if I should be answering these questions right now or at the end. I'm going to go over, so basically motivation. Keep your motivation. Don't be scared to do something, okay? If you're saying, you know, I'm scared, or, you know, if you're scared because you're going to, anyway, so my point of the bad manufacturing was I learned so much from that. I learned so much about product, and I learned so much about how to make a great product. I've also dumped tons and tons, like thousands and thousands and tens of thousands of dollars into different people that have worked on websites for us. And it never really went how we wanted it, but I learned so much from it. I learned, you know, how not to make a website or who not to hire. But through the bad experiences, you know, we Googled on, okay, how can we make this better? How can we make this better? And we wouldn't have been able to do that, if we hadn't had our bad experience, right? So I don't say that any of our experiences are bad. I feel like we've learned from all of them. And we've never dipped low or anything. It's always been great. I mean, you know, obviously when we had all those trays go flat, we just throw everything away and start new. And but it's okay. If you don't have trial and error, you never grow and you're never appreciative of the things that you get later, right? So fast forward now, we do have great eyelashes. They do not go flat, I promise. okay, that was that question. I'm gonna go over my, okay. I think I'm good on the things I wanted to go over, so now I'm gonna go back and answer the questions. Basically, in 2000, we started taking our product distribution and manufacturing, we started taking that very seriously in 2014. So it took me 4 years, from 2010 to 2014, to really figure out how to do product and how to actually make money doing it, right? You know, for the first while, we were just putting all of that money back in. We still do put a lot back in, but we actually pay ourselves now, which is nice, right? Okay, so I'm gonna go back and answer these questions. I'm only going to answer the business-related ones this time. I feel like I do a lot of these on products. So, okay, at what point did you decide to move away from lashing? Oh, I answered that. Did you ever take ideas on new product? Oh, do you ever take ideas on new product? Yes. If you ever, you know, are like, oh, I wish you had this. You know, we totally understand that one product company cannot serve all of your needs. But we're always wanting feedback from you guys. So feel free to email us anytime. My email is extensionsbylindy@gmail.com. Do you have certain qualifications or certifications in order to teach? You took the lash course and then taught after 4 weeks, and how much did you charge for the course? Okay, so I would not recommend learning how to do eyelashes and then teaching 4 weeks later. I'll tell you why I did that. So Yes, thank you. Sorry, I should clarify. I did that because I learned in 2010, and there was one person who knew how to do eyelash extensions, okay? So if any of you guys know Hillary Brand, I was her very first student. So Hillary Brand, I was her very first student. And she had given me so much praise and so much, like, you're so good, you're so good, you're so good, that I was like, okay, I think I can do this. So I was in hair school at the time. And after I took my course, all the girls were like, I want to learn, I want to learn. And I'm like, okay, we'll go to her. It's $500, you know? And they were like, oh, I can't afford that. And so I was like, okay, well, you know, we're in hair school. We had nothing better to do. So I just taught every girl at the school how to do it. Anyone who wanted, I just did lashes in front of them. You know, it was not a formal class by any means. They had no book. They had no nothing, but I just taught them how to do it. So over time, I realized, I think I can charge people to do this. I think I need to write a manual. I think I need to give out a certificate. I think I need to have an actual 2-day course, you know? So my first, like, 15, 20 students, they were free. Yeah, I didn't know what I was doing. And then I think I started out, I charged $100 and I made them buy their own kit on top of that. And then I slowly got to $500, and then I slowly got to $6, and then I slowly got to $7 and $8, and so on from there. But yeah, I want to sell your product. Oh, you're so sweet. We currently don't offer anyone to sell our product. How did you go about finding a manufacturer? Research, working hard, motivation, and never giving up. I want to sell your product. Oh, no, sorry. We don't offer our product to be sold by anyone right now. It's just not something that we want to dig into. But maybe in the future we will. What business classes do you recommend, such as marketing, social media, etc.? Okay, I really love Jenna Kutcher. She's phenomenal. Phenomenal, phenomenal, phenomenal. I've learned so much from her. I bought a couple of her courses. I just read a book. I finished it today. I think that's why I was super motivated to do a Instagram live. I read You're a Badass at Making Money. It was an incredible book. It was on Audible. It was about 4 hours long, and I would totally recommend it to anybody. There is another marketing person. Let me see if I can look her up on my phone. Maybe Shayla, or, shoot, what is her name? I can't think of her name, so you guys will have to come back. But you know, if you feel like, okay, I've reached my max, I've taken enough eyelash classes, I'm really good at eyelashes, which you, in order for you to say that, you need to have taken at least 3 or 4 classes, I feel like, personally. But yeah, then I would say move into other things. Don't put all your focus on taking eyelash courses. You know, we don't have to be good at everything. My biggest thing that I've learned over from 2010 to 2018, I think the biggest thing that we have done to help improve our business, so now I say, do what you do best and hire at the rest. So, for example, you know, when we first started, we took pictures of our own product, which was fine. You know, you all start somewhere. Now we hire a photographer. We have a photographer come in about every 4 to 6 weeks, and we do photo shoots of products. We do photo shoots of eyelashes, we do more products. We usually spend a full day, and I use those images. Make sure your images that you're using on all of your social media and your website, they're professional, nice images. I highly recommend that. You're gorgeous, I love your products. Thank you, Botanical Radiance, I like your name. I wish you had an eyelash tray with at least just 2 strips of colored lashes and just a bunch of different colors in one tray. I know, colors are really, really, really hard. They're not commonly sold at all, so they're hard for us to really decide to sell. Do you need to be certified in order to teach? You need to be certified in eyelash. Well, I mean, I don't think you, well, I don't, it depends. Okay, Let me pause for a second. Obviously, you need to have your licenses and you need to have your certifications. Each state will be different on what they recommend for you to teach eyelash extensions. So I would definitely call your state board. Just Google, say you're in California, state board, cosmetology state board, California. Google, and you should be able to find a phone number that you should be able to call to ask those questions. I feel so confident using your products. I know I'm putting the same products on my clients' faces that I have on my own. Oh, you are so nice, Chrissy. Chrissy Duriso, thank you. Great book, amazing book. Hey, some of you guys have already read it. That's awesome. My next book, I feel like we all should read a book together. So type in recommendations that you have. I already bought my next Audible. It's called Present Over Perfect. Oh, let me look. I think I'm gonna start tonight. But we should read one together. Start a book club. An entrepreneurship book club. So the next one I'm reading is Present Over Perfect, but I don't think it's a business one, so I think I need a business one recommendation. So another thing that I recommend is surround yourself with people that have a mindset like you. If you surround yourself with people that are complaining about their jobs or lazy or not hardworking, you may start to become like them. So surround yourself with people that are on their A game. They are motivated. They have an entrepreneur mindset. They want to be better. Surround yourself with people like that, and I think it can really help you. Lindy, I seriously love how far you've become doing lash extensions at Gianni's, even though you're amazing. I know. Thank you, Ashley. When will some of the most popular tweezers be coming restocked? Tweezers restocked tomorrow. We've restocked two of them over the weekend. We just didn't announce it. But the 207 was restocked over the weekend and one other one. The rest of them will all be restocked tomorrow. Will you get the L-curl in 0.15? I will write that down and keep it in mind. Book club, yay! Like a book club, yes. I'm reading it too. It's amazing. We should do live once a week and talk about it. We totally should. So we need a good business or entrepreneurship or some sort of book. Did you say that last Audible book was You're a Badass at Making Money? Yes. So I'll show you my last Audible book. It was really great. You are a, yes. So it's, oh, it's starting. So this is the last one that I read. Oh. You Are a Badass at Making Money by Jen Sincero. If you don't have an Audible, it's amazing. You can listen to it while you do clients or while you're driving or just want to tune your kids out or your husband out, your dog out, whatever. The Compound Effect. Okay, I'll look that one up. Yes, you attract who you are. Thank you. Thank gosh for tweezers. I wish I could work with you. I think it would be awesome. I want to work with someone who's passionate as I am. It is so hard to find people that are passionate like you and that are hardworking. I feel like they're becoming fewer and fewer and fewer. 12/7. High Performance Habits. Brendan Butchard. 4-Hour Work Week. We did read that one. That was a good one. I couldn't agree with you more. Kate, does anyone have any business questions? Ask me any question, and I think I should be able to answer it. Like I've talked about everything I want to, I think. But yeah, I feel like how to get more clients. Ah, I feel like I went over this in the beginning. Oh my gosh, you're gonna make me cry. Lashes by GTA. I don't wanna talk about things I already talked about, but I did talk about how to get more clients at the beginning. How you have to do a lot of knocking on doors. People will not knock on your door. Your clients are not just going to come flooding in the doors. But working really hard in the beginning. They say that in the beginning you have to give like 40% of all the effort that your business will need to really start up, and then after that it's really just maintenance. How do you feel about lash artist training via Facebook or Skype? I've been seeing a lot of that lately and I want to try, but I've never heard of them training FaceTime or Skype. That's interesting. We have pre-recorded videos that we do sell for training. But before people sign up, I always say that you should be very, very self-motivated, and a quick learner. And there should be one other thing, and I'm kind of just not thinking of it right now. I feel like those almost take more time. I think it depends on the student though. But I feel like they might take more time because they're not there in person, so sometimes it's just a little harder to understand. I don't know. I have mixed feelings. But I feel like if you think you can do it, try it. You don't, what do you have to lose? That's my motto. Try it. What do you have to lose? Indies, stories, or post? I don't know what you're talking about. Cecilia. I'm glad you're doing live. I know this is business related. I'm getting overwhelmed with my clients. When do you close your books? Never close your books. Raise your prices. If you're in high demand, raise your prices. I want to know what people's ideal client. What do you mean? Oh, Cecilia. Insta stories or posts? Shoot. Tell me your whole question, Cecilia. I don't know what it is. And Karen, tell me your question. Sorry. I want to know what people's ideal client. Do you have tips for social media marketing? Tips for social media marketing. First tip, follow Jenna Kutcher. Do whatever Jenna Kutcher says. And buy whatever training Jenna Kutcher is selling. Other social media tips. Be consistent in your posting. Quality over quantity. Don't put your, but also don't be too hard on yourself. Quality over quantity. And look at your social media. If you have not switched it over to a business account, you need to switch it over to a business account. I'm going to give you like 5 secrets that are really, really good to have for your business account. Make sure your location is on there. You have 2 seconds to grab people's attention. If you confuse them at all, they're gone. Make sure your location is on there. Make sure how to book is on there. Whether it's by calling you or texting you or emailing you, make sure it's clear. Make sure, and these are all things that you're putting in your bio. Make sure in your bio it says professional eyelash extensions or master eyelash artist or name yourself. Give yourself an actual title, and one that sounds like, oh, that sounds nice, rather than just lash artist. Make yourself, why do people want to come to you? So adding things like master lash artist or advanced lash artist or EVL certified lash artist, adding things like those to your title, will make you more intriguing to others. And be consistent with your posting. Make sure you respond to the people posting on your feed. There's no point in having a social media if you do not respond to these people. It's unprofessional and it's unprofessional. Make sure you're responding to people. So right here in your, okay, I'll give you a couple more social media tips because you guys are so nice to stay with me this long. Okay, so I'm gonna pull up my Instagram. Okay, so everybody see, find a color theme that will go good. Okay, mine is black, whites, and grays. Okay, I kind of got a little bit off right here during Valentine's Day because I added in some pinks. But if you can see right here, it's more blacks, whites, and gray, and our logo color, which is kind of a turquoise color. Stay within your theme, okay? Choose some fonts. Stay within your fonts. Stay within your colors. Stay within your region. So that when people see that, they think, oh, that's EBL. They're not like, whose post is this? Personally, I don't like watermarked photos. I feel like it distracts from... So I will not repost anything that has a watermarked photo. So I like this photo. It's clear. It shows exactly what she's doing, eyelashes. And it's not watermarked. But that's totally my opinion. Google, you know, do your own research. Google and say, should I watermark my photo or not? Any professional photographer will never watermark their photo. Anyone can steal it, yes, but they don't watermark it. So, yeah, I never recommend watermarking. Okay, another tip. So, once you've switched over to a business profile, you can go here. Oh, whoops. You can go here, Insights, and you can see your stats. So, it will show you what days are good for posting. And you can also go down to... Sorry, I can't read backwards. It goes down to like, it can show you the hours. Okay, here we go. Oh no, here we go. Shoot. Of course I can't figure it out because I'm trying to show somebody. But you can go into your insights and you can see what days are good for posting. What hour was a good post? How much, basically when you got the most feedback. And then you can go here, look at your posts and see which ones got the most interaction and post more photos like that. So whether it was a picture of your work or it was a picture of a giveaway or it was an educational post, and mix your posts up. I feel like this is a whole nother topic though, so I should do that one next. Okay, I'm gonna answer a couple other questions. Did you guys like that? Hopefully. Tips for social media. How can I go about finding a manufacturer and tips on choosing a good one or the right one? I feel like I'm not going to answer that question. I'm sorry. I want to do your online training. I know most of how to do eyelashes. I just would like to have a certification from you. You're so sweet. Botanical Radiance. Where are you located? So we do offer refreshers. So if you have a certificate, say from a classic eyelash extension from a different company that you've already taken, you can come and take a refresher from us. It's $300, and you can take it in person. It would be one day. so we do offer refreshers. Not a business question. Do you guys sell flat lashes? We do not sell flat lashes. I only sell things that I'm a fan of, and I'm not a fan of flat lashes just for lots of reasons. How do you feel about pre-made lashes and do you use them? I do not use pre-made lashes. I feel like they are too heavy, and they kind of take away from the beautifulness, the customization of volume lashes. I convinced the salon I currently work for to buy your products and they were so happy I recommended them. Our clients are even happier. Oh my gosh, you are just my new favorite person tonight. Thank you. I hope I can find out your name. Tell me your name and I'll remember. Put your name with your Instagram name, Botanical Radiance. With price raises, should you lock in old clients at original prices or just increase everybody? Increase everybody. Your old clients aren't gonna leave. If they've been with you and they love you and they love your work, they're not gonna go anywhere. And if they do go anywhere, they're probably gonna get crappy work and then they're gonna come back to you and love you even more. Your clients aren't gonna leave. What are your thoughts on pre-made volume lashes? Just answered that. Who are the people you've trained with? Okay, good question. Sorry. I hope these questions weren't super old and I hope you guys are still here. My first training was with Hillary Brand. I was her very first classic student ever. It was a good class, but I was her very first student. So I kept that in mind now, you know, 8 years down the line. My second training, okay, no, wait. So I did Hillary Brand, and then I didn't take a course for a while. So my second training, I had just gotten married, and instead of going on a honeymoon, I went and took a volume training, and it was Teresa Smith. She's from London. She has really curly afro hair. Her class was phenomenal. That's where I very first learned volume lashes in 2013. I went to LA. My third volume class, third class was Loretta J. Okay. And then I went to a conference in Arizona that had classes in it. It was like a NISA thing that I don't think is around anymore. And then after Loretta, I took Trina Maven Artistry. And then I actually took Trina Maven Artistry again, but it was kind of a different course that she put together. So those are eyelash courses that I've taken. Now, another thing that I've done, I've gotten together just with groups of people that have taken other courses, and we've kind of shared information and kind of just played around with each other and different products. I feel like it's always good to have other friends that are in the industry that are willing to help you better yourself and you better them as well. Even though we are in the same industry, it's, I don't know. Will you be saving this live? Yes, I'll save it. My social media page is all over the place. Set a goal. That will be your goal this month. So this month, She Lash Bar. Because remember, we're going to do a goal a month, right? So you are going to improve your social media. And then write down three ways that you can improve it. Whether it's by taking better images, whether it's by choosing some colors that you'll stay within the theme of, or whether it's responding to your customers. Choose a couple of goals how you'll improve your social media. Colors on top of colors. Hey, some people are totally rainbowed, and that's fine, but make that rainbow your theme. Could you repeat the name of the social media person to follow for her tip? Yes, I will type it right here in the comments. Social media person to follow. She's incredible. This is not... Oh, I'm totally spelling it wrong. She's Jenna Kutcher. She has a podcast. It's called the Gold Digger Podcast. And it's great. I love the social media tips. Social media live would be great. Yes, I need to do a social media live. San Marcos, California. My name is Annie. Annie, nice to meet you. I don't know where San Marcos, California is. But we do have a trainer in San Diego, and she's phenomenal. She's in San Diego. How far is that from you? I'm in Maria Mesa. Tentacle Radiance. Huh? I'm confused. What was the person's name? Jenna Kutcher. I'd choose a lash class over a honeymoon any day. Oh, man. How can I come up with ideas to choose a business name and logo? So this goes into hire, do what you do best and hire out the rest. I have a great person that I can refer you to for, find her Instagram, for design. She can make you a logo. The best thing to do is go on Pinterest, make a board of things that you like, and then send your designer, I like this theme. And they'll probably have you answer a couple questions, and then, so this is who does a lot of work for us. Her Instagram is Carly Creative. So hire someone to do that for you. I am not creative at all. I have no creativity to me. I cannot draw a stick figure. I can't dress myself. I don't know how to put on makeup. If you haven't noticed, I don't wear makeup because I don't know how to do makeup. I am not creative or fashionable at all. That's why I have hired someone to do our marketing, because I would know, or I shouldn't say our marketing, because I take marketing classes. So I mean our logos, our design work. So I'm not good at that at all, and I have no desire to learn anything about that. Same with photography. I can't take a photo to save my life. So I hire a photographer. Do what you do best and spend your time doing that and hire out the rest. I took your course at HG Las Vegas in 2017, graduated in August, and was hired right after I graduated. I said it's huge cleaning my basement dream. You think, oh my gosh, you were so sweet. Brandy. I think I remember you. It's your picture. Yes. Good to hear. Come comment on something. come comment on something on my feed, Brandy, so I can remember and go follow you. I've been a hard wax specialist for the past 5 years and I'm now switching over to lashing. I've yet to take a course, but have one planned for this coming Monday. I'm so grateful to have found you. Good. Good luck on your class, and I hope that you ask a million questions while your trainers are there. Can you talk about risks associated with breathing in glue all day? Any tips to minimize negative side effects? Wear a face mask. There are fabric ones and there are carbon filtered ones. I would just recommend the reusable, fabric ones. Those will be great. I don't know that it's been proven that there are many risks associated with it. I know that you can get a headache from breathing in the fumes so long. But yeah, just purchase your lashes and use them on a client. Super obsessed. Thank you. Shit. Katarina. Sorry, I probably totally butchered your name. San Diego is only 4 to 5 minutes. Oh my gosh, you, Botanical Radiance, you need to go and see Elizabeth. Her Instagram is Hua_creates. She's a San Diego trainer. She's the San Diego trainer, and she will blow your mind. She will. Hello, Splash Tapes. Backwards, we can't see the Instagram words. What? Oh, I'm sorry, my phone was backwards. What iPads do you recommend? I like the pink iPads, they are my favorite, but our most sold are the white iPads, so I would say buy a box of each and then whichever you like from there, reorder. Do you have trainers in Atlanta? No, I don't have any trainers in Atlanta. I'm so sorry. Our closest trainer probably to you is in Indianapolis. And her Instagram name is Lashes by Matic. If you search EBL on Instagram, most of our trainers should pop up. What is your take on using nano misters? Any trainers in Portland? Sorry, two questions at once. We don't have any trainers in Portland currently. What is your take on using nano misters? I like nano misters for people that are sensitive. And if I'm in a really dry climate, I really like a nano mister because it will seal the deal. Your adhesive cures by adding water to it. So just a little bit of water can go a long way. So a nano mister is just micro misting little mists of water helping to cure your glue, which is transitioning it from a liquid to a solid, which is what it needs to do. Are you still supposed to use a sealant finisher before you use the nano mister, or is it recommended? Yes, a sealer is great if you're doing classic lashes. If you're doing volume lashes, I would recommend not to use the sealer. You can use a sealer at the end of the treatment. You can use it before you nano mist or after. It really doesn't matter. What are your requirements via a trainer? I just switched my salon to your products. I love it, and I've tried many, many, many of them. Thank you so much. Wink and Dink? Cute. Wink and Dink Studio. Yes, how do you become a trainer? We aren't looking for trainers, so I'm just gonna skip over that question. I'm so sorry. But yeah. Oh, or do you mean a trainer in general? Just start your program, start your curriculum, call your state board, make sure you have everything, all the certifications and licensings that you need. What does a nano mister do exactly? So a nano mister, I have them right here. This doesn't have any water in it, but this is a nano mister. Closed, open, right? So you open that thing up, sprays a little bit of water. Your client's face will be about here, depending on how strong your mist is. And you're just gonna mist it, and that water is what cures your adhesive. So your adhesive needs to transition from a liquid to a solid, and it needs to cure, it needs the fumes to stop. So nano misting will help do that for you. Also, here is our newest product. It was right here too, so I figured I'd show you guys. It's a cute little dental mirror, and people use these so when your client's eyes are closed, they look like this, so you up there can see their lashes. Cute, huh? Okay. I said I would only be 30 minutes. Thank you. And it's been an hour, so I'll take like 2 more questions if anyone has any questions, and then I will sign off and save this. All adhesives need to be cured. not just ours. They're all made of the same ingredients, just variations of the ingredients. Most are cyan acrylate based, and it requires water to transition from liquid to a solid. Do you charge to a mentor? Yes. I don't know where you are, Shilash Bar, but you can email me. Answer my glue, I'm panicking. I think was your glue question at the very beginning. Ask me your glue question because I don't know what it is. Sorry. Some of these questions kind of get lost. I'm trying to scroll, but I think it's kind of pointless. So tell me your glue question. I've heard people patch tests on the arm as well as the lashes. Your take, please. Your eyelash your adhesive is never applied to the skin, so you do not need to patch test anywhere on the skin. You do that just for hair color, so that's why some people get it confused. If I'm going to do a patch test to see if someone's allergic to the eyelash adhesive, I would do 5 to 10 eyelashes on each eye. And I would do them really short, the length of their natural lashes. Botanical Radiance. Thanks for following. I know it's a long time and it's late and you guys are very busy. Her question was in the beginning. I know, I don't remember her question. Hopefully she asked. Thank you so much. You have been so helpful. I'm going to scroll up and look for a question one more time. Still not getting anywhere with looking for it. Oh, she asked it again. Okay, thanks. I got glue in my lid and I can't close the lid to my adhesive properly, and now I have one of those needle things in there. Is my glue going to dry out? Yes, if you can't glue to your glue bottle, it's going to dry out. So what I would recommend is getting a little cup of acetone, putting your glue lid in the acetone to get that glue that's stuck in there out, and then wash it really well with warm soap and water to make sure you get all of that acetone off. And then put that glue back on there. Put that lid back on there. In the meantime, try and cover it maybe with a piece of foil. Like a good solid piece of foil, maybe like 3 or 4 pieces of foil. Until you can get some acetone to clean out your lid. Did I answer that right? Sorry, you stayed this whole time. You are such a righteous, good customer. Oh, Instagram is kicking me off. Apparently you're only allowed to do a live for an hour. I think this is new. And I have 1 minute and 45 seconds remaining. Oh my gosh. I didn't know that they kicked you off. Thank you guys, all of you guys, so much for watching. If the glue gets tacky after like 30 minutes, does that mean it's old? I've only had it 2 weeks. You need to be replacing your glue dot every 20 to 30 minutes. When it does get tacky, you just need to replace it. It doesn't mean that it's old. If you buy Grand Rapid from us, the manufacture date will be on the bottom. What does EBL stand for? It stands for Extensions by Lindy. When I started out of my basement doing eyelashes, I named it Extensions by Lindy. It's so, so stupid. But I hated that my name was in there. I don't really like people reaching out and referring as Lindy. Only when there's bad things, I don't like it, because then I feel so much pressure, like all the blame's on me. So I didn't like my name in it, so I switched it to EBL. Why? I don't know why she's asking why. Too funny. Bye. You're the best. Thanks so much, Lindy. Thank you guys for watching. Hilarious. Take care. Thanks, Lindy. Okay, DM me. Is it okay to just leave the glue pin until the 4 weeks is over? I would put the cap on just for extra safety. Thank you so much for answering my questions again. I really appreciate your help. Okay, thank you guys. Email me if you have any questions, extensionsbylindy@gmail.com. Visit our website, eblashes.com, and thank you.